situation to test Job. And the first thing that Satan did to test Job was he killed Job's entire family except for his wife, his servants he killed, and his animals he killed. Pretty horrific in all acts of Satan, not acts of God. And then after that, even after that, Job would not curse God. Job still loved God and he refused to sin in any way. But because of that, Satan said, well, that wasn't hard enough. He didn't have any physical pain. So Job asked God if he could test, or Satan asked God if he could test Job again, and God said yes. So this time, Satan tests Job by making him in excruciating pain, by putting huge sores all over his body. And even then, when Job cursed the day that he was born because he would rather be dead than by being in this pain, he still refused to curse God. Even Job's wife told him, curse God and die, but Job refused. So this is a book of a very righteous man who had so many horrible things happen to him. And today we're going to read from the 31st chapter. And in the 31st chapter, Job is explaining to his friends that he is blameless, and Job is begging God to listen to him and to give him justice. Essentially, Job is pleading for a fair trial with God. But the book of the 31st chapter in the book of Job is kind of long, so we're going to skip through. So first, we're going to start with verse 3. Does not calamity befall the unrighteous, and disaster the workers of iniquity? Does he not see my ways and number all my steps? If I have walked with falsehood and my foot has hurried to deceit, let me be weighed in just balance, and let God know my integrity. If my step has turned aside from the way, and my heart has followed my eyes, and if any spot has plumped my hands, let me sow and another eat, and let what grows for me be rooted out. Now we're going to skip down to verse 18. For from my youth I reared the orphan like a father, and from my mother's womb I guided the widow. If I have seen anyone perish for lack of clothing, or a poor person without covering, whose loins have not blessed me, and who was not warmed by the fleece of my sheep, if I have raised my hand against the orphan because I saw that I had supporters at the gate, then let my shoulder blade fall from my shoulder, and let my arm be broken from its socket. For I was in terror of calamity from God, and I could not have faced his majesty. And now for the last three verses, we're going to go to verse 35. Oh, that I had one to hear me. Here is my signature. Let the Almighty answer me. Oh, that I had an indictment written by my adversary. Surely I would carry it around on my shoulder, and I would bind it to me like a crown. I would give him an account of all my steps. Like a prince, I would approach him. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Through Christ Jesus, our Lord and our Savior, we pray. Amen. How many of you have had something